I was going to say, with Rowland V. Lee, what I love about him is he seems to have encouraged actors to take unusual risks or to go places they didn't go. You see it particularly with Basil Rathbone. The first time Basil Rathbone worked with Rowland V. Lee was Love from a Stranger, which is one of my favourite Basil Rathbone parts. And it's interesting because it's British as well. It's not a Hollywood film. It's a British film taken from an Agatha Christie novel. And Basil goes absolutely berserk by the end of the film. And it's amazing to see. I mean, it should be laughable. And it is kind of sort of so intense that you start kind of chuckling, but it's very scary as well. You know, he has this kind of crazed smirk through the latter sequences, and it's great, and it's pure theater. But he never did that before with any other director, and he did it again in Son of Frankenstein. You see him going to that edge of hysteria. On the one hand, it might be Basil saying, "I'm not taking this seriously. I'm going to ham it up," or is it an actor saying, "How far can I go? How far can I take this characterization?" Because I think it leaps off the screen when he does that stuff.
Lee, I mean, expanded Lugosi's part in that as Igor.
He was the best friend I think Lugosi ever had in Hollywood as far as directors were concerned. I wish he'd directed more movies with Lugosi, because it was clear that he respected him and wanted to see, well, what can he do? What can we give him to do? And it's beautiful performance.
Oh, it's fantastic. And it shows the range that he had, right? I mean,
yeah. Which
credit for.
I know. And it's I mean, everyone loves Igor. Everyone loves that performance. It's even if you didn't like Bela Lugosi, you'd still like that performance. I love that book, by the way, Bill. I really do. I think it's it's really well written, and it's really informed my thinking about that documentary and has made me quite passionate about doing it. I mean,
Thank you.
Yeah, no, honestly, because I think I was a little bit in kind of thinking I have to do Chaney, but thinking that Chaney Sr. was the one that I really, really admired. But your book made me really reassess Chaney Jr. and look at his performances and look at what he was capable of. And, you know, he's a wonderful actor. He's another subject that I really wanted to make a film about, and this gives me the chance, because Lorre is just, he's a fascinating figure, because he just had so much more talent than Hollywood could handle, in a way. And but, you know, forged a really successful career.
It was another one, again, that didn't phone it in, you know.
No,
from the intensity of them, you know, to that great almost cameo in Casablanca, but you can't forget him.
No.
And then,
no.
Of course, you know, you get into the Face Behind the Mask, and you get into, you know, Five Fingers, you know, Beast with Five Fingers, et cetera. And then all those things with Vincent Price, where they just, I mean,
yeah.
Fantastic.
You can see with Vincent Price that they really liked each other. They really enjoyed working together. Do you know they did I'm sure you do know this, that they actually had a TV series piloted in the late 50s.
No, I did not know.
Where Price and Lorre are antique experts, and, you know, but it kind of becomes like a sort of detective thriller thing, because, you know, there's usually someone has been killed for this antique. You know, with Boris, we sort of started with Frankenstein and how he suddenly is famous, and then we tell the backstory. Well, I think with Basil Rathbone, we go in at the top of his career, which is 1939, the greatest year in cinema. Yeah, and there he is. He's been this character actor. He's been this villain, and suddenly stardom is his. You know, he's above the title. He's playing Sherlock Holmes. It's like, it's all happening, and, you know, but, you know, it doesn't quite play out the way it should. You know, because he signs a contract because he wants to do the Portrait of Dorian Gray, and that doesn't happen because MGM.
Oh, Herb Hadfield, right?
Yeah. Well, George Sanders got the part. Yes.
He was up for the Sanders part. Okay.
Yeah. One of the first plays I wrote when I was about 13 years old was basically a horror called The Trial and Execution of Boxer Rebel, in which I cast myself as this serial killer who's awaiting sentence. This tale about a serial killer being tried, and I attack the judge, and I get shot before they actually hang me because I'm so berserk. And but the thing was, I wrote it as a serious, stark, serious play, and how it came out was this black comedy with all these like Scottish kids with their wee voices saying these lines. And there was a scene where my sister, after I'm shot, she runs over to me and she grabs me and she says, "Boxer, Boxer, tell me you're not dead." And she started slamming my head against the stage. And it was like, "Boxer, Boxer." And the whole audience absolutely erupted in laughter. It was huge fun.